If you are a beginner to meditation, do you struggle with negative thoughts when you sit down to meditate? If so, then this video is just for you. In this video, I'll share some tips that you can use to address these negative thoughts. And I've tried and tested these suggestions, and I assure you they work. If you are here for the first time, my name is Kiran. I'm an author, and I write about emotional resilience, mindfulness, and wellness. And the link to my book is in the description below. Now, a few weeks back, someone on social media reached out to me with a question, and he said, "Kiran, I'm a beginner to meditation, and when I sit down to meditate, I get negative thoughts like I am not good enough, I can't do my business, I can't live a happy life. These thoughts make me feel even more stressed, and then I don't feel like meditating. What do I do with these negative thoughts? How do I deal with them?" So first of all, thank you so much for your question. You know, I will say that one thing that majority of people don't realize, I am sure I didn't when I started meditation, is that when you start to meditate, everything in your life, especially your thoughts, become magnified. It almost feels as if someone turned up the volume on the inner critic. You know, it's like when you see something through a magnifying glass, it becomes magnified. Meditation does that to your thoughts. They become magnified. Where before you might have said, "Hey man, I have these thoughts that are negative from time to time." Now when you start to meditate, you're like, "Jesus Christ, I have a gazillion negative thoughts." So just an FYI, you are not alone. When I started meditation, I had the exact experience, having tons of negative thoughts, and quite honestly, I was shocked at the amount of negativity I was carrying in my life. And even though these negative thoughts that I would have didn't make me feel good, instead of walking away from them, I just got very curious. I was like, "Why do I think like this? Why do I have these negative thoughts?" You know, one of the things my meditation teacher would often say, that when you come into this world, when you're born through your mother's womb, you don't come into this world saying, "I'm not good enough," or "I can't live a happy life," or "I am not, you know, fill in the blanks," but rather you come out beaming with joy, with hope that this is going to be the best life ever. But what happens is that through your upbringing or your life experiences or the genetic line in which you incarnated, you often take on negative beliefs. And most times, you know, we are not even present to these beliefs unless we get to a point where we say, "My life doesn't work." Or you sit down to meditate and then all of a sudden, you are present to these negative thoughts and negative beliefs. Now, all of us have these negative thoughts to some degree. So right off the bat, you're not alone. But you know, as humans, we have this tendency to not want to look at anything negative, be it negative thoughts or emotions. Like for majority of us, our first instinct at something negative is, "I don't want to deal with this." And so we feel anger. And to be honest, that's how we are conditioned. Like you feel angry, but you act all is cool. You feel fear, but pretend you don't feel a thing. And rarely, you know, do we stop and ask ourselves, "Why do I feel this fear every single day? Why do I feel angry?" But instead, we shove these emotions under the rug. Now, if you dare to shift your mindset, you will notice that these negative thoughts are actually your friend. Because in a way, they are pointing to all the negative beliefs, negative patterns that you have accumulated in your life and that you must let go of in order to live your highest potential. Then the $1 billion question is, how do we let go of these negative thoughts? Well, I'll share the approach that I took to address them. So every single day when I would meditate, I would keep a journal and a pen next to me. Say I meditated for 10 minutes. At the end of 10 minutes, in my journal, I would write all the dominant thoughts I had during meditation. So for example, you know, I would write thoughts like, "Oh, my friend owes me money. Now I have to remind her. And this makes me feel very angry." Other days I would write, "I think I'm not doing enough. And this makes me feel guilty." So I would write down the thought and how it made me feel. And in looking back, this was perhaps the most important thing that I did. Looking at thoughts and the underlying feelings that they created. So one thing that you really want to focus on when you have a thought, start tuning into, paying attention to the feeling. And I know I'm repeating this because this is such an important concept. And if there was just one thing you were to take away from this video, then let it be this. Like, really get to the undercurrent of what feelings are driving your thoughts. Is it anger? Is it shame? Is it fear? Is it guilt? Or is it something else? Like, maybe when you have a thought like, I am not good enough, the feeling that it creates in you is anger. And maybe in someone else, the feeling it creates is guilt. So your thoughts and your feelings are going to be unique to you based on your experiences. And when you do this exercise consistently for a few weeks, for a few months, you will start to notice patterns in your thoughts and in your feelings. Like, when I did this exercise, after a few months, what I realized was that if I took all my thoughts and grouped them by feelings, I would have three main buckets. One bucket for anger, one bucket for guilt, and one bucket for shame. Meaning, if I looked at all my thoughts, they either made me feel angry, or they made me feel ashamed, or they made me feel guilty. And once I had clarity on these underlying feelings, as in what feelings were really driving the thoughts, then the focus was to address these feelings individually. Like, one of the feelings that often came up to me, like I shared with you, was guilt. No matter what I did, I would feel guilt left, right, and center. If I missed meditation practice, I would feel guilty. If I missed my friend's birthday, I would feel guilty. If I traveled alone, I would feel guilty. And this guilt got so amplified during my meditation that I really had to address it, because I couldn't imagine how I could live with so much guilt in my life. And as I started working through guilt, addressing it, which for me meant learning to accept that it was okay to make mistakes, that it was okay not to live by other people's expectations. And the more I interrupted my normal mode of thinking that made me feel guilty, what I noticed was that during meditation, I had relatively much less negative thoughts that created guilt. So just to recap, again, my best suggestion to deal with these negative thoughts is that when you sit to meditate, start paying attention to your thoughts and what feelings those thoughts are creating. And then once you have clarity on these underlying feelings, start addressing them one by one. And really, think of these negative thoughts as your friend, because they are asking you for emotional healing. They are telling you where you are emotionally stuck and where you need to change. And the method that I just shared with you, it is the most gentle, simple, and effective way to address these negative emotions. Like, if I were starting out in meditation right now, this is the advice I would give myself, because it really works. I hope these suggestions were helpful. As always, please only take what resonates, discard the rest. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, share with your friends, subscribe to the channel, and I will see you in the next video. Thank you.